Hey warriors, it's Victoria coming to wish you a happy new year. I hope you're doing well as we enter into 2021. And I just want to share with you some habits that I created during recovery that really served me in getting my health back that I intend to take into this new year. And so I just want to dive in because I've got about 10 of them that I want to share. And the first one is having a daily shot of wheatgrass. And though I don't do this every single day, I do it most days because it's very quick and easy, and it floods my body with a dose of intensive nutrition, like vitamins, minerals, electrolytes. Anyway, it's an excellent little thing to do every day. If you're interested in looking into this habit, I've got a video. I'll put the link below about how you can make it, and it takes about 10 minutes. And it's just a real energy-enhancing and vitality-inducing habit. So the second habit that I'm taking with me that, oh man, I really had to learn this through recovery was boundaries. And, you know, I did a lot of Mickel therapy, and in fact, I finally trained as a Mickel practitioner because it was so useful to me in recovery. Pre-CFS, I was very fuzzy on my boundaries. I kind of had a hard time understanding where I stopped and other people began. And I often acquiesced things that were important to me in order to meet other people's expectations. And so this area has become really important, is learning the language of boundaries, having the skill set to serve me. Okay, the third thing I'm taking with me is restorative movement. Now, before I got sick with CFS, I was really driving myself in the ground. I had a very full plate. I was homeschooling my beautiful kids, and I loved homeschooling. It was my passion. I was helping my husband in marketing with his commercial construction company. I was also attending events like several times a month, you know, formal events and getting all dressed up and going to these events that just did not feed my soul. And on top of that, I was doing a very intensive karate workout. And so basically, I just drove my body into the ground. So I didn't understand that exercise should really be something that is restorative, that makes you feel good, better than when you started it. So that really helped me when I was recovering from chronic fatigue syndrome, was not thinking about exercise, but thinking about restorative movement. Okay, the next thing I'm bringing into 2021 to me is creating the hygge factor in my daily life. And thus, all the cozy scarves that I have on right now. My daughter gave me this scarf at Christmas because she knows I love being hygge and being cozy. So there's a great book called The Little Book of Hygge, which has really impacted my life because it's a Danish philosophy of creating coziness in as many pockets of your day as you can. And so for me, that is things like, you know, turning on my little Himalayan salt lamp, having fairy lights in my bedroom, cozying up in deliciously soft and textures like these scarves, cozy blankets, building a fire and having my family over and having some good fun conversation. That's all cozy hygge. And when I can't build a fire, well, my husband is the one who builds the fires actually, but when we don't have a fire in the fireplace, I love to click on YouTube, either on my iPad or on the big screen, and watch either a fire, just have it in the background. They have all these ambiance videos, and this season I've really gotten into snowfall and little fireplaces. So anyway, those things have really enhanced my hygge factor, and it really brings a sense of well-being and comfort and happiness to my life. And so I'm definitely bringing that with me. Next habit is scripture affirmations. If you've watched some of my videos, you know that I like to use brain retraining, and I use scriptural affirmations to speak over my body for health and wellness, vitality, energy, joy, confidence, anything that I'm needing. It's good to speak it because our bodies are listening. Okay, the next habit is self-care and beauty routine. And so, you know, during the days when I was bedbound, I started discovering things on YouTube about face yoga, face massage, making homemade face masks. And so since I didn't have a lot of energy to do other things, I was able to start developing these little self-care routines. And they have just become a real important part of my life. They bring centering and balance and a sense of calm. The next habit is creating balance in my life. So in my daily planner, I like to write down at the beginning of the week, health, family, mission, hobby, and spirit. And so that way at a glance, sometimes I'll, you know, put a number 1 through 5 on what I've been doing lately. And that helps me know where to direct more energy this week. So if I spent a lot of time with the family last week, working on the house, I might want to do more of my mission and my work during the following week. Next one is the KonMari method. You might be familiar with the book. I think it's called The Magic Art of Tidying Up. And it's the Marie Kondo method of creating a space that you really enjoy being in, you know. And so I started with little micro purges in a drawer, and then it moved to my closet. And then after the holidays, my husband and I dove into the garage and did a huge clean out. Hadn't done that in 10 years. It was loaded with boxes. We're still not finished. We're working through it. But it's a whole process of learning how to let go of things that no longer serve you and deciding what things bring you joy. And the interesting thing about this is it flows over into the rest of life. So it's about relationships and work and all kinds of things. So I'm definitely holding on to the KonMari. I'm starting her next book about sparking joy in work. And I'm very excited about that. The next habit is something I learned out of necessity in recovery, where I had to break tasks down into smaller projects. Even in the beginning, it was like making lunch. I couldn't even stand and make a sandwich in one go. I take that same concept into the projects that I'm doing now, and it's really helpful for me. It helps make tasks manageable, and it helps me, again, create balance, because I don't feel like I have to finish a project once I start it. I will give myself a little place that I want to get to in it and then stop there, and then that way it's easy for me to come back and pick up where I left off and finish it at some point in the future. The next habit I'll be taking into 2021 is self-hypnosis. And, you know, hypnosis is used for people that can't take anesthesia during surgery. So it is a very powerful mind-body practice. And right now I'm excited because I'm getting certified in hypnotherapy. And so I record little audios for myself. Originally I was doing it on things like sleep and, you know, well-being. And it's fun to take that in anything that you want to do, like energy, vitality, youthfulness, exercise, whatever, you know, I can do little audios that support me. And I also want to start doing some and putting them on my channel. So if you have any suggestions, let me know in the comments below. And then the last thing that I definitely want to bring into this habit into 2021 is sharing things that help me in recovery with others that are still struggling with CFS. And I started this early in recovery, and I say this because you may have experienced some ground taking in your recovery, and it can be such a help to other people. And by finding a vehicle to do that, whether it's doing a blog or doing videos like I do, or having a forum, or, you know, just posting in a forum, sharing what you've learned. For me, I found early on that was a healing balm, and it helped me sharing that information with others as I learned from them as well. So anyway, that's just something that I want to continue on into the new year, and I look forward to doing that with you. So what are some habits that you've created that have served you in recovery that you want to take into 2021? I'd love to hear, so leave me a comment below. I hope that this video has encouraged you that the habits that you're creating now are really going to serve you once you get your health back and for the rest of your life. So if you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a like and subscribe to the channel if you'd like more information and inspiration in recovery. And if you haven't already, be sure to join us at CFS Warriors Academy on Facebook. It's a fabulous forum where the mentors that help me in recovery, my coaches, are each sharing from their professional experience on modalities that help them heal from CFS. So anyway, warriors, take care and remember, life's not over, it's starting again. And I speak life, health, and wholeness over you.